What's going on, everyone? Today I will be storing my motorcycle for the winter, or as us in the north call it, winterizing a motorcycle. So when you store a motorcycle for the winter, there's a lot of things that you have to do, because you're going to have a machine that is sitting with a full tank of gas for 5-6 months, maybe 7, whatever, until winter's over, basically. And the object is to do everything the most efficient way possible. So basically the steps I'm going to be doing today, I'm going to start by filling the gas tank, and at the same time I'm going to treat the fuel, because there's a lot of steps after that that require you to run the engine. And this way the fuel treatment gets in the lines, and then the fuel is stabilized until spring. After that, I'm pretty much going to be taking off all these side panels so I can gain access to my oil filter. Another thing that's going to do is that's going to allow me access under this cover, so I can give the front sprocket a really good cleaning, get all the fucking old wax and grease and shit out of there. And then once that cover's off, I'm going to run the actually, I'm just going to spin the rear tire, spray the whole chain down, just with some basic degreaser stuff. I like this brand because I think it just melts all the old wax and shit off there. I got like a little scrubber thingy. I guess it's meant for like tile and stuff, but it works awesome. After the chain is clean, for those of you guys that don't have access to a hose, like right now, all the plumbing is turned off outside because of how cold it's getting. I have this little thing. It's a wooden masonry sprayer, or a lot of people would call it a pesticide sprayer, whatever you want to call it. It's nice because it's a gallon. You can fill it with really hot water, and then just, pump it up, basically. And, shit. You pump it, and then, it sprays. So that's nice for rinsing off the chain and all the under stuff there, where I have to get all that old motorcycle, like the grease and all that shit off there. It's just nice because I don't have to bust out a hose or whatever. Plus, I don't even have access to a hose. So after all that's clean, the chain is like sparkling clean. It has a new fresh coat of chain lube on it and all that shit. Then I'm going to start the motor. I'm going to run the motor until it reaches pretty much the operating temperature, which is like right around 200. The fans kick on at 215, so I usually just run it until the fans kick on, turn the motor off, and then I have to drain the oil, which on this bike I don't think I have to take off my underfairing. I'm really hoping I don't have to take off my underfairing because it's a pain in the ass. So hopefully I can get away with just taking off the side panel. I think that one long black piece there, I think, is the only thing that I have to take off to get access to my oil filter. So that would be awesome if that's the only fucking thing that I have to remove. And then, let's see here. What else do I have to fucking do? I have all my shit right here. I'm using a K&N, KN204, because this is an 07R6. So, and then I have AMSOIL's new, what they call metric oil. It's the same thing as their old motorcycle oil. It's, wet, clutch safe and all that stuff. And the manual recommends 10W30 for the climate that I live in. This is my gas canister. This is, I'm actually going to be putting the fuel treatment in the tank and then pouring this on top of it so it mixes well. This is just a little crappy fucking alarm clock that I'm going to listen to music on because it's really boring. Gloves, and then this is just like old socks and fucking old t-shirts and rags and shit just for wiping stuff off. So, and then I obviously have my, this is for filling the crankcase, and this is for draining the oil. And then I'm just going to find like an old 1 gallon milk jug to dump the used oil, and then I can take it down to have it recycled. But I'm just going to kind of walk through these steps as I'm doing them. So this is what I'm using this year to store the motorcycle, is Startron. I've never used it to store before, but people online, especially boaters, swear by this stuff as far as storing fuel. So you pretty much just open up your fuel tank and this calls for a fluid ounce every 3 gallons for the initial dose. That's like the strongest strength that it is. So you basically just take it and, you know, put about an ounce in there. That was a little, about a half an ounce. That was closer to an ounce, maybe an ounce and a half. The good thing about Startron is that you cannot overdose on it. I mean, you can't run the bike on just Startron, but it's hard to overdose on it, so. All right, so now that the fuel treatment is in there, I'm going to pour the gas in there. You'll notice that the bike is on a paddock stand. The reason is when you store your motorcycle, you want it to be upright, because if it's leaning, you won't be able to get as much gas in there. And you want to top that fucking tank off as high as it will go to prevent any room for condensation to happen. So, yeah, pretty much just pour the fucking gas in there until it's full. All right, so at this point, the fuel tank is topped off. It's literally sitting right at the top of the filler neck. I've already loosened up all these screws, and I have a little push pin. One thing you want to be really cautious with if you're doing this in the cold is all your little metal or all your little plastic pieces are going to be extremely sensitive. So the last thing you want to do is yank on them too hard and crack something, and then you have to fucking replace it, and it just makes the project more of a pain in the ass. So I'm just gonna get the side cover off. All right, so I got that side panel off. A good thing to do is to keep all the parts that go with that part in a separate spot. So I have this is called a mid fairing, I believe, and that's all the little pieces and shit. So that just opens up the side so I can gain access to the shifting linkage and get this little cover off. If you have an R6 and you notice and you're like, oh shit, I don't have those wires, you're not gonna have these wires. These are from my underglow, which are on the back side of the mid fairing. So don't worry about that shit. So anyways, I just wanted to show you guys what my chain looked like before I start cleaning it. It's pretty fucking gross. It's all covered with dirt and shit. I haven't cleaned it in like a month because I haven't been riding much, so I'll be sure to show you what it looks like afterwards. So anyways, this is why I take the cover off. If you see all that shit in here, it's all old chain lube and dust and rocks and whatever. Luckily on the R6, this entire piece pulls out, so you don't have to clean it while it's hanging over everything else and washing all that filth in the way. These tubes are a pain in the ass, but those can just kind of tuck out of the way on the R6 anyways. I'm not really sure how other bikes are built. It is evident that I'm going to have to take the bottom fairing off. Because otherwise the oil is going to be everywhere. So I do have to get that out of the fucking way, as well as get those hoses out of the way. But relatively it's clean now because I got this thing out of there, which this obviously needs a thorough fucking cleaning because that shit's just caked up on there. So at this point the chain sprockets look like 100% better. Everything's all fucking cleaned up on both sides. Gotta make sure you get the back side of the chain too, because otherwise you'll have rust you don't know about. So as you can see, there was a lot more stuff that had to get out of the way before I started it. Right now I'm letting it run, and then I'll loop the chain, and then after I'm done doing that, I'll change the oil. Getting that bolt out of there and an oil drain. Careful, that fucking exhaust pipe is really fucking hot. I generally prefer not to drop the bolt into the pan, but if you do, it's not really a big fucking deal. Definitely want to wear gloves for this because the oil is real fucking hot. I can feel it a little bit dripping out. And that is some dirty, dirty oil. Dirty. All right, so now that the oil has drained. Got the filter off. I wiped off my exhaust pipes. That'll probably smoke in the spring because you can't really get all the oil off. Next thing you're going to need is a torque wrench, you know, that's adjustable in foot pounds or newtons or whatever. My drain bolt is 35 foot pounds of torque. So what I usually do is I set it for 15 and go up to 35 after. So the lines on this thing are not the easiest fucking thing in the world to read. Right there is 35 pounds. So right there, 35 pounds. Take some of the new oil, not the old shit, if I can get this fucking thing open. You just want to take a little bit of the oil out of there. You get it on your finger, whatever. And then just get it on the fucking seal real good. Make sure it's really like saturated with oil. Some of these K&N oil filters come pre-moistened, I guess. This one did not. So hence why I'm lubing the shit out of it with oil. And I want it to get right down in there and all the little cracks and shit and the threading. Anywhere where there's going to be contact with the engine. So that's pretty well lubed. And then I just take this fucking thing. You want to make sure that also that surface where this touches down to, you want to make sure that's clean as fuck too. Just because you don't want debris in there or dirt, because it'll possibly cause a leak if there's anything keeping it from making a really good seal. I just spin that sumbitch on there like that. So right now, it's about like hand tight. Right there. It's about as tight as I can go with my hands. Okay. And I grab this. I probably should attach a wrench to the other end of it. So, take your wrench and do, I was actually wrong, it's a quarter turn. Quarter turn, and that's all she wrote. That fucking thing is not gonna leak, trust me. Okay, so at this point, I've got the fuel filter, I've got the oil filter installed. I got the, this little piece here is actually the sensor for the kickstand. So it can tell if the kickstand is up or not, and it'll cut the engine if it doesn't sense that the stand is up. You know how it works. I've got all the tubes rerouted. These have all been cleaned. I got all that shit off there. So that chain guide and then the cover are all back together. At this point, all I have to do basically is reconnect this little shift arm thingy, and then I'll put the under fairings in, and then I'll do the mid fairing and pull it into the garage. It looks like it's gonna rain like any second now, and I'd rather not do this in the fucking rain. So yeah, I'll check back with you after the fairings and everything are on, and then I will be putting the oil in the bike. Well, there it is. I got everything back together, got all my fairings back on there, I got my mid fairing back on. One thing you want to pay close attention to when you're reassembling the bike is you want to make sure all your electrical connections are connected. Like, I had to plug my turning signal back in, my underglow. I had to reconnect those little connectors there. All the bolts are in the right spots. I got all these little push pins are back where they're supposed to be, all the way up and through there. This armature and everything is all back on there. It's torqued down to what the shop manual says. Doesn't really matter if you leave your kickstand up or down. The bike's not going to run again until spring, so it really doesn't matter. I like to leave it down on the side of error Just because in the spring you might be in a rush to get back on this fucking thing, not realizing that your stand is up, and you take it down off your other stands and it fucking tips over, and then that's like the shittiest way to start a riding season ever. When you store your bike for the winter, here in New York it can get like negative 20 out, and that is horrible for your tires. It can cause flat spots and everything else. So you want to get your tires up off the ground. I have a rear paddock stand that sits on these little spools. And then this one here is called the triple tree stand. And as the name suggests, it supports the bike by the triple tree. This stand goes up and under there. You probably can't see in there because it's too dark, but there's a pin that goes up underneath into the triple tree and holds the bike, and it hovers kind of off of that stand. So you can turn the wheel, you can work on your tires, your brakes, your forks, whatever, while it's suspended by that triple tree. My oil filler cap is still off. I still have to put new oil in there, and the shop manual calls for 2.75 US quarts, which I have three. I always have like a quarter left over that I just save to use as a general purpose, I guess, lubricant for anything that I need. All right then, so far I have got two of my quarts in the engine. I'm not gonna add that last one yet, and let me show you why. What I usually like to do is, after I add the two quarts, because the engine's still kinda warm, the oil is still going to flow to the bottom correctly and all that bullshit, about now is when I check my dipstick to see how much oil I have to add, because you can always add more oil. It's a pain in the ass to take it out. So right there, that's kind of dirty. I probably should wipe that off on something. Oh yeah, so I'll use an old sock, which is part of my rag collection. Like I said in the beginning, lots and lots and lots of rags, because you'll use them all. Clean that off real good. Stick that fucker back in there. All the way in, all the way out. And it's showing that I need to add about a quart. Okay, so put that fucking thing back in there. Like that. It's getting colder by the second. This sucks. Anyway, what I did was I opened up this little cap that looks like it takes a coin or whatever. You can use a coin or just a really big flathead screwdriver. And that gives you access to the, I'm not even sure. I think it's the crankshaft, but I have no fucking clue. All I know is that when you spin that, it turns the motor over manually. What this is doing is, this is cycling the oil through the engine, and it's going to get it into the filter. That way, when you check your dipstick, it's going to be more accurate. So this one happens to be a 12 millimeter. And when you start turning the engine over, it's only going to want to go one way. So it's kind of hard to fuck this up. And it's usually forward. So you'll feel it as you go around right there. You can kind of feel the valves moving because it'll go in steps like there. That was easy. That was easy. Then it gets hard again. What you're actually doing is you're moving the cylinders inside the engine, and you're cycling the oil pump manually. I mean, if you had the bike in the on position and you did this fast enough, you could probably hand crank the motor like an old-fashioned car. But more or less what you're doing is you're just turning the engine over a couple times, because you don't want to start it now that it's winterized. You don't want to run the engine again. So just crank the motor over by hand a couple times. Or, you know, 10, whatever I'm doing here. But you can feel like that, you can actually hear it out of the exhaust. You can hear the fucking exhaust valves and shit. So anyways, now that that's been turned over a couple times, I take my dipstick out again. And I gotta wipe it clean. See, now it's all covered in oil because it's been splashing around in there. So that's clean again. Take that, dip that in there. And you can see the oil level went down a little bit. So that can go back in there. And you really don't need to turn over the engine again, because you've gotten the oil into the filter. And Yeah, the seal on that looks pretty clean. That goes back on there. And you really don't need to torque that thing down. I'm not sure if other bikes have this access to the engine like that, but I know my Honda did, and my Yamaha does, and my other friend has an older CBR, and I'm pretty sure his had that. I remember seeing it on the side of his bike. So at this point, you can go ahead and put the rest of the oil in. I have 1 quart left, and I only need to put 75% of it in there to make my 2.75, quarts, US quarts. Any mechanic I've ever talked to in any forum that I've seen of people that actually know what the fuck they're talking about will tell you to change your oil before winter, and here is why. Oil, as it sits in your summer, or sits in your engine all summer, it gets a little bit of gasoline mixed into it. That's why new oil smells sweet, and that's why old oil smells like gasoline, because it gets in there and it contaminates it. It's just part of how an engine works. There's going to be a little bit of blow-by on your piston rings, and that will, some of that escaping gas will contaminate the oil. If you leave contaminated oil in your engine all winter, okay, that oil is very acidic, and it will cause the inside of your motor, because most modern sport bikes have aluminum blocks, it will cause that aluminum block to pit and to rot, basically. So that is why you change the oil before winter and not after, is to get all that old dirty oil out of there. You get nice fresh clean oil in there, and then you could turn over the engine a couple times just to make sure it cycles around and gets into every little fucking nook and cranny that old oil might be hiding. Because obviously when you drain the engine, unless you're actually washing it out with something, you're never going to get all that oiled oil. You're more or less diluting it to the point where it doesn't even matter anymore. So that's pretty much all there is to winterizing a bike, is just, cleaning the hell out of the chain and lubing it and make sure it's not going to rust while it's sitting. Go through your entire bike if it's warmer out and actually clean the thing. I didn't clean this one, but I will. I don't need to have the battery in it or start it to clean the fucking thing, so I'm gonna wait until a day when it's not shitty out like this. It's just really cold today. I started this project at like 1 p.m. It was around 48 degrees. Now it's closer to, maybe like 38 degrees outside. It's getting really cold really quick, and I only probably have like a half hour of sunlight left. So, for today, my mission was to get the oil changed and to get the bike on stands. I'm not even sure if I'm gonna pull the battery today. I probably won't, because I'm fucking lazy and I've literally wasted, like, I don't wanna say wasted, I've used like half of my day off just to change the oil. One of the pain in the ass things about not having your own garage is if you forget tools, you gotta fucking get in your car and you gotta drive all the way home, which for some dumbass reason, every single year I always seem to forget something. This year it was something as stupid and small as my fucking open end set. I have this cheap little bag of open end wrenches, and I happen to leave one at home because I need it to get into this little space to release that shift linkage. Such a pain in the ass. But unfortunately, I do not have the room in my own garage to store this thing all winter, because we have a lawn tractor in there, we have a generator, and we have a snowblower. There is no room to store a bike. It would have shit laying on it all winter. My brother's garage, as you can see, is fucking huge. We store other shit here. It's just easier. But just a word of warning. If you're going to use somebody else's garage or somebody else's storage space, just make a checklist of tools, which is probably what I'll do next year if I actually think about it in time. Make a checklist of every single fucking tool that you're going to need. Like, if you need certain, these little hex bits, I have a whole little fucking set of those. I just got fucking tools like everywhere right now. Open-ended wrenches, crescent wrenches, torque wrenches, gloves, anything you need, make sure you have it with you, otherwise you're gonna be running back home a lot. It saves you some time. But I will finish this video on another day when I pull the battery and finish cleaning it and winterizing the motorcycle. And then basically at that point, it's just gonna sit just as it is all winter. I'll throw a sheet over it. It's usually a good idea to take like some kind of paper towel or old shirt and jam it into your fucking exhaust pipe to keep mice from getting in there and making a new little home. So for now, all I'm doing is filling up the rest of the oil, and then I'll come back when I'm ready to pull the battery. What's going on, guys? I'm on the final stops here to get the motorcycle winterized. Basically, all I have to do today is I have to remove my seat. On the R6, there's little things under there, little Allen screws. And if you have a wrench with an extension, it makes it a lot easier. Wow, those are fucking tight. Holy shit. Ooh. Yeah, that thing was on there unnecessarily tight. You definitely don't want to lose these little bolts, because they will fall into the fucking body of the motorcycle and you'll never see them again. So, that's the positive. It was disconnected. Just kind of, you know, tuck it out of the way somewhere so it doesn't slap up on there and make contact again. And then I just take my little bolt and immediately return it to that spot, so there's no chance of losing it. And then, Jesus, I don't know why the fuck I put those on so tight. No hindsight there. And then negative comes off. I'll bring it right back up here where the positive is and just kind of tuck it away. And then take the bolt, put it right back in the battery. So that is that's exactly where it's going to sit until spring. Is right there. Everything's done. Oil's changed. Gas is treated. Battery's out of there. It's up on stands. I don't have to worry about my tires. Everything's good. So that is how you winterize a motorcycle.